नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, हमेशा खुश रहो बिटिया। आई एम जेवियंस डॉक्टर नीरज धोलिया, फैकल्टी ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड वेटरनरी साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ, वुमेन यूनिवर्सिटी, जयपुर। सो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस प्रैक्टिकल सेशन, दैट इज फेलिंग टेस्ट, टू परफॉर्म फेलिंग टेस्ट। सो द एम ऑफ द एक्सपेरिमेंट टुडे इज टू आइडेंटिफाई द कार्बोहाइड्रेट फ्रॉम अदर बायोमोलिक्यूल्स यूजिंग द फेलिंग टेस्ट। So first of all, the Fehling test is performed for the carbohydrates. Okay, so let's understand what is the principle behind this test and how to perform this experiment. So, principle. So Fehling solution can be used to determine whether a carbonyl containing compound is an aldehyde or ketone. So if we want to confirm that a carbonyl compound is made up of the aldehyde group or a ketonic group, so we can use this test to determine the their presence. So a specific complex known as the bis tartratrocuprate second complex, it is found in the Fehling solution. So this complex is an oxidizing agent and the active reagent in the test solution. So the compound to be tested is added to the Fehling solution, and the mixture is heated. So this compound will oxidizes the aldehydes and giving a positive results. But ketones do not react with this complex unless they are alpha hydroxy ketones. So this complex oxidizes the aldehydes to carboxylate anion. And this process, the copper two ions of the complex are reduced to copper one ions. So the red copper oxide then precipitates out of the reaction mixture, and it indicates the positive results. So this is the principle behind this test, and this is the reaction. Okay, so this is the complex which is formed in the Fehling solution. Okay, so this complex react with the aldehyde groups and gives the red precipitations. So the material required here is the Fehling solution, definitely. So there are two type of Fehling solution A and Fehling solution B. So what is the Fehling solution A? It is a 0.7% cupric sulfate pentahydrate solution. Okay, so you take 0.7 gram of cupric sulfate pentahydrate and dissolve in 100 ml of the distilled water. And Fehling solution B is you can prepare the Fehling solution B by dissolving 350 gram of the potassium sodium tartrate tetrahydrate and 100 gram of the sodium hydroxide in 1000 ml of the solution. So this is how you prepare the Fehling solutions. Then you need test samples or test tubes and pipettes. Then how you perform? So this is the procedure. You will take 1 ml of Fehling solution A and 1 ml of Fehling solution B, 8-2 ml of the test solution, mix well and boil it, and try to see the red precipitation of cuprous oxide that forms at the end of the reaction. Okay, so if the red precipitation is there, then your test is positive, otherwise negative. So thank you, hope you are satisfied with this detailed session, and if you have any query, please write in the comment box. I will resolve your query. And this session is powered by digital version 2, Jyoti Vidyapeeth, Women's University, Jaipur. Thank you.